Andrea, a healthy 22-year-old college student, a high school gymnast, gets a swollen sore on her right wrist. The pain is mild, but it doesn't seem to improve. What she thinks as a simple spider bite turns out to be a challenge and an immediate threat to be resolved by the public health department. Stay tuned to know more. Andrea lives with her mother and her younger sister, who also happens to be a high school gymnast. She is trying to work for her psychology class, but is having a hard time because a red swollen sore on her right wrist is making typing difficult. Why won't the spider bite heal? She wonders. It's been there for days. She makes an appointment with her doctor so that she can show him the now painful lesion. Although Andrea doesn't have a fever, she does have an elevated white blood cell count that indicates a bacterial infection. Andrea's doctor suspects that this isn't a spider bite at all, but a staph infection. He prescribes a beta-lactam antibiotic called cephalosporin. Now, what is a staph? Staph is the common name for Staphylococcus aureus bacteria. The name aureus, derived from the word aurum, comes from, you guessed it, due to the golden yellow colored colonies formed by the bacteria, which are carried on the skin of about 30% of the human population. Although Andrea is diligent about taking her antibiotic as prescribed, she doesn't seem to be improving. After 3 days, the lesion on her wrist is even larger than before and is now draining a yellow pus. Andrea develops a fever. Her mother insists that she calls her doctor to tell him about the latest developments. Now, why does Andrea's infection persist after her treatment? The Staphylococcus aureus bacterium responsible for Andrea's infection is resistant to the beta-lactam antibiotic prescribed by her doctor. Concerned about what his patient is telling him, Andrea's doctor calls the local hospital to let them know he is sending a patient over. In the emergency department, a nurse swabs Andrea's wound and sends it to the hospital lab for culturing. The culture shows that Andrea's infection is caused by MRSA. Stands for Methicillin-Resistant Staphylococcus aureus. MRSA produces beta-lactamase enzyme that destroys beta-lactam antibiotics. The attending physician surgically drains the pus from the sore on Andrea's wrist. But how does a normal bacteria, which usually falls like flies when treated with an antibiotic, develop resistance against it? Mutations develop randomly in bacteria. Some mutations are lethal, some have no effect, and some may be beneficial. These kind of provide superpowers to them. Once these mutations develop, the offspring of the mutated parent cells also carry the same mutations. Because they have an advantage in presence of the antibiotic, bacteria that are resistant to antibiotics soon outnumber those that are susceptible to the antibiotic therapy. The widespread use of antibiotics selectively allows the resistant bacteria to grow, whereas the susceptible bacteria are killed. Eventually, almost the entire population of bacteria is resistant to the antibiotic. The emergency department physician prescribes a different antibiotic, vancomycin, which will kill the MRSA in Andrea's wrist. She also explains to Andrea what MRSA is and why it's important that they find out where Andrea acquired the potentially lethal bacteria. What can an emergency department physician tell Andrea about MRSA? The first MRSA was healthcare associated, HA-MRSA, transmitted between staff and patients in healthcare settings. In the 1990s, infections by a genetically different strain, community-associated MRSA, CA-MRSA, emerged as a major cause of skin disease in the United States. CA-MRSA enters the skin abrasions from environmental surfaces or other people. Andrea has never been hospitalized before now, so they are able to rule out the hospital as the source of infection. Her college courses are all online, so she didn't contract MRSA at the university either. Then how did she get the infection? The local health department sent someone to her family home to swab for the bacteria there. MRSA is isolated from Andrea's living room sofa. But how did it get there? After speaking with family, the representatives from the health department, knowing that clusters of CA-MRSA infections have been seen among athletes, suggests swabbing the mats for MRSA. Andrea's sister, although not infected, transferred the bacteria from her skin to the sofa where Andrea laid her arm. The point to be noted here is that a person can carry MRSA on the skin without becoming infected. The bacteria entered through a scratch on Andrea's wrist. The use of antibiotics without a medical prescription is quite a prevalent habit among us. To be frank, even the medical health department isn't very cautious about it. These practices have and will for sure elevate our already existing problems to a whole another level. So thank you for watching this video. We'll be coming up with new content soon enough. Until then, bye bye, take care.